morning, everyone. I'm Kylie Wilkinson. I'm the Labor candidate for the seat of East Hills, and I'm here in Conder Park this morning with Chris Minns, the New South Wales Labor leader, and Prue Carr, the deputy leader. We're at the Uniting White Dove Early Learning Centre to make another great New South Wales Labor announcement. So I'm going to hand over to Chris now to make the announcement.
Thanks, Kylie. Thanks, everybody. Thanks to the United Church. It's wonderful to be here with both Kylie and my colleague Prue Carr, Shadow Minister for Education, Deputy Leader of the Labor Party. Look, this is an important announcement for New South Wales Labor. We are going to supercharge the early childhood workforce in New South Wales. We know that if we invest in the people who provide early childhood education, it can make a major difference, both for the children that get that education, for the New South Wales economy, and for communities right across this state. The investment today will make a real difference. To break it down, it's $22 million. $9 million for scholarships, $10 million for upskilling for those that are already in the workforce, and $3 million in research to understand, crucially, how the workforce can be skilled up into the future. $22 million, money well spent when you consider the future education of young Australians. We know that for every $1 invested in early childhood education, the economy benefits from $2 of output. There's positive implications for a reduction in the amount of welfare used by people in the community, a reduction in crime, enhanced and increased educational outcomes for those that have access to early childhood education. And of course, it's crucially important when it comes to female participation in the workforce. We believe this is the best investment we can make for future generations of young Australians. By putting money into the education system, it is the most important investment and gift that we can hand to the next generation in this country. That's why New South Wales Labor has been focused on early childhood education with the announcement of over $400 million for 100 early childhood centres right across New South Wales to be built concurrently with new school builds in the state of New South Wales, as well as $60 million to be invested into non-government schools to provide similar childcare and early childhood education, and a major investment in primary and secondary schools right across New South Wales. Only Labor has a plan to increase educational standards for young Australians. We know over the last 10 years we've seen a dramatic decline in outcomes when it comes to schools and education in this state. We used to be ranked third in the world when it comes to science. We've dropped all the way to 23rd. We were ranked sixth in the world when it comes to reading. Again, we've dropped to 23rd. We were ninth in the world in the top 10 when it comes to maths outcomes. We've fallen all the way to 31st. Prue and I remain worried that the graduation rates in New South Wales are at 72%, but if you look in Queensland and Victoria, the graduation rate is above 80%. If they're not in school, we want them in vocational education and TAFE, but we also know that when the government was elected, there was about 52 to 54,000 apprentices. That number has dropped to 25,000. So whether it's early childhood education, primary, secondary, or vocational education, Labor has a plan. We'll invest in the people we need to provide essential services in New South Wales. And over the last 12 years, the New South Wales government has had a fair go at trying to fix the crisis in education in this state. They haven't done it by now, and they're not likely to do it over the next 4 years. Indeed, I've watched Mr. Perrottet closely over the last 5 weeks. He seems to be offering the parents of this state 4 more years like the last 4. Only Labor has a comprehensive plan when it comes to education of young people in this state, and that is the best investment we can make in the future generations of young Australians.
Prue.
Sure. Thanks, Chris. Educational outcomes in this state are in free fall, and today's announcements are just the latest in Labor's plan to actually do something about declining educational outcomes. So many of our commitments to the parents of New South Wales to arrest these educational falling outcomes are to do with investing in the people that deliver education to our children. Whether it's actually tackling the chronic teacher shortage in primary and secondary schools, or today, significant announcements to upskill the workforce in early childhood education and preschools for our children, for our 0 to 5, for our 3 and 4 year olds in preschools. We know that we need universal preschool for all of our children so that they can get the very best start in life. But not only do we need to build preschools and help schools to build preschools, as Labor has committed, We need to do something about the workforce that is inside early learning centres and preschools that are doing the critical work of caring for and educating our littlest people, our most vulnerable littlest people. This will make sure that there are scholarships available to early childhood educators so they can critically upskill, so they can upskill to diploma or bachelor degrees, so that centres can have a wider range of qualified experts within their centres to encourage more people to work in early childhood. We've seen a critical decline in workers in early childhood, so we can get more of our young people, our very young people, into early learning settings, into preschool, and then their transition to primary school. This is the latest announcement in Labor's plan to do something about the underinvestment in education and radically declining education outcomes under the Peter-Taylor government.
Chris, we're all happy to take questions.
Chris, wouldn't it be easier to attract more childhood educators if they're paid? Isn't that the real problem?
Yeah, part of it is, of course, pay and conditions, but we need to make sure that we're looking at every possible policy alternative to lift and upgrade the skills in New South Wales. We know that in New South Wales, early childhood education centres, those with a diploma or a degree is about 45%. In Victoria, it's above 60%. And we know that, particularly for early childhood educators, there's a real need and a willingness to get upskilled if you're already in the profession, to go to a diploma, to go to a degree. They do need help. We've been listening to and talking with both the workers on the front line that are providing the care as well as the peak bodies, and they regard this as an essential investment in the future of early childhood education.
How would staff apply for this sort of money to receive it?
Similar to the existing Department of Education diploma schemes that are already in operation, there's well-established protocols in place for people to make an application for one of these early childhood scholarships. We anticipate over 3 years, 500 people will benefit from the scholarship, with it being capped at $25,000, but also $5,000 being available to certain scholarships. And that's not including the professional leave that we'll fund to counter and counteract burnout, particularly amongst many childhood early educators who are finding it very difficult to do their job, a job that they love, a job that they believe is a vocation, but they obviously need help.
So it's 500 over 3 years you expect to take this up?
We anticipate 500 over 3 years with scholarships from about 5,000 to up to 25,000.
Obviously the TAFE offers these sorts of diplomas. Why not just make the diplomas free?
Yeah, we've obviously looked at enhancing TAFE and we've made announcements in relation to minimum funding from the New South Wales government when it comes to vocational education going formally to TAFE. But I've looked at opportunities elsewhere in the economy to strengthen vocational education and training where I see that it's working. And that includes trades training centres of excellence for manufacturing in Newcastle, Wollongong and Western Sydney, but also our Hydrogen Centre of Excellence, which has been a joint project from the trade union movement and industry associations to upskill workers in the emerging technology associated with hydrogen. Now, that is obviously not government run, but it's a scheme that's working. And I think what Labor has shown in this election campaign is we're prepared to look at ideas and initiatives that we believe are working in the real world, and we'll back them if we think that we can upskill them and put it at scale to affect and help more people.
Donna Davis, Mr. Menz, are you going to take any action against her with regard to what she said a few years ago?
Look, I take her at her word. She was speaking about internal Liberal Party issues and obviously the inability of the Liberal Party to attract and retain and promote and run women in senior positions. And look, she's an extremely trustworthy person. I've always taken her to be a person of her word, and I'm sure that's what she meant when she had this interaction.
Chris, apparently some of those who were receiving end of the comments are going to take out stack decks to prove their side of the story.
Look, they're entitled to do that. I just remind everybody, we're in the middle of an election campaign. Donna's obviously running for the state seat of Parramatta. The people that are up against her are advocating on behalf of another candidate, but I'd stand by Donna, absolutely. She's someone who's committed to that community. She's worked tirelessly as the Lord Mayor of Parramatta. She's run a positive and optimistic campaign about what's possible in that fast-growing part of New South Wales. And I take her at her word. I mean, it's self-evidently the fact that the Liberal Party have found it impossible to attract and retain women to run for seats right across New South Wales. There was a stat out yesterday indicating when it comes to safe seats, the majority of them, the vast majority of them are men, not women. And I think of the New South Wales Cabinet, there's 16 Liberal positions, just three are occupied by women. So despite the Premier's best intentions and public rhetoric, he hasn't been able to deliver.
And just last night, the Liberals dumped their candidate for Wyong over comments he made. Do you think it's appropriate that a mayor and someone who is running for Parliament makes comments similar to what has been alleged about Donna Davis? Do you think that's appropriate?
Well, there's no similarities between the two, and I think fair-minded people would see a world of difference between the comments made by the Liberal Party candidate on the Central Coast and a Lord Mayor of Sydney who's explained the circumstances.
What do you make of the...